Hello, it is Monday. I'm out walking in the woods. It is soon the sun goes down, but I still have some time out in the light. And I think I'll talk a bit more about what I talked about the last few times and a bit about this music festival event. You know, the name of the... So first of all, just a little recap. I did a video about... what was it about? So heart problems. And then the same evening, I think, or maybe the day after, I don't remember. Astro World Festival, they had like 11 heart failures. Like that's not supposed to happen. That shouldn't be. That's the wrong kind of thing that they ended up on the hospital for. If they supposedly are pushed, they shouldn't have problems with their hearts. There should be something else. Okay. So, and we have all these stories. If you look online, you find stories about people talking about demonics. And like when they entered this festival, they walked through a mouth. So they were kind of consumed when they went into the festival. And there's more like absurd things. If you search for this Astro World Festival, you will find a lot of weird things. People saying that there are more people saying that it was kind of demonic than you find people saying that they are pushed. I mean, there's a lot of people talking about we were pushed. But the other main thing was like this energy or demonic that they felt. It felt really bad. They wanted to escape from there or something. Okay, so weird stuff. And what to say about that? Let's just leave this subject as fast as possible, because it's quite unnerving, or what do you call it? It doesn't feel that nice to talk about it. So this is the thing. When I talked about these heart problems and the day after something happened, and this is not the first time, and I actually tend to forget all this. It happened so many times, so I don't even keep count. But when I looked back, what was it? Yeah, it was this artist in Sweden. Lars, he was in the accident. That was also, I made videos about that. It was also related to what I talked about. It's not the first time. I shouldn't be the only person this happening to. I think there are some of the commenters that are saying like it's the same for them. They talk about something, or they think about something, and then it happens. And I wouldn't, like, when you become kind of, so Matt, most of my subscribers are also subscribed to Matt on Quantum of Conscience. And if you are not, I think you would like that content, because we are similar. So Matt, he talked about how truthers go through different stages, like how, to what degree are they truthers, and so, what were I going to say? So in my opinion, this is really important, in an important stage of development. Okay, so in my opinion, There comes a time, because during all of this process, at least for me, the paranoia started growing on me. You know, the more you learn about these things, the more paranoid you get. And then according to me, at least, after a while, when you realize that, like, this world is a cartoon or something similar, maybe you, or at least I, lose my paranoia. I don't have the paranoia anymore. And so when, if you think about something, like there were someone commenting, I don't remember the names right now. So, like, they think about something and then it just pops up on a commercial or something. Or they just pass by a car looking a certain way and they get some commercial about it. So this makes people paranoid, and they think that someone is looking at them through the camera, and someone is, the super AI is spying on them. But maybe not. I mean, maybe it's just, as I said to that person, it's just your light that is lightening up the surrounding, and it kind of is reflected back, and you see this commercial just because it is, I mean, if the world is a lot of things and maybe a lot of dead things and you are alive, then the dead things may reflect your own light back, and this makes it appear like someone is spying on you, but maybe not. I would say, like, no. Okay. And all this, I'm changing subject now. I actually have a little note about things to talk about. But this is, as usual, I just talk about whatever, I guess. So there are these cameras everywhere, and they are there for you to feel that, like, Satan is close to you. It's Satan's eye. Satan's eye wants to be everywhere, even on art. So this all-seeing eye, it's there to, it's the same subject, the all-seeing eye and the paranoia. At some time you realize that it's just maybe your own imagination playing a game with you. Sure, I'm still not sure about this, of course, but I have chosen the path of not being paranoid. And I think there's other people like me that, I mean, you, I think many of you listeners can, I hope so at least, that you can turn on and off your paranoia when you feel like it. I hope so, because I think it's needed. Okay, so how can I talk about the rest now on the note? There is no possibility. I have to just change subject. Maybe I can go there in some way. Patterns from the future. Brain awareness. Okay, I like this brain awareness subject. Maybe I'm repeating myself a bit, and I mean, it's nothing new in this, I think, this recording. Maybe something, I don't know. So, what about the brain awareness? I don't know how to describe it, so, because this is very new to me. I'm thinking like this, for me at least, when I discovered the Detroit fractal, okay? it was like something triggered in my connection to everything and my influence, and it's almost like I became like Michael Jackson. because Michael Jackson is from Detroit, and like Eminem is from Detroit, and they have like great power and they are very influential, like, and in some way it feels like I got some of this energy from Detroit, the Detroit Track Club. And the reason for this could simply be that, I mean, my thesis for the Detroit Track Club, my theory about it is that the Detroit fractal is kind of the world, it's all of it, and it's everything is just a copy of Detroit or something, and it's so fucking absurd, so you can just laugh about it if you want, but I mean, it's so fucking absurd. I agree totally, but when I just studied this, everything pointed in the same direction to this absurd conclusion, so I embraced it, and I got this influence now. Like, before I didn't. It wasn't the same way, of course not. And now, and this ties into the like big brain of awareness, because once you start to see the frame, someone is whistling. Once you start to see the frame of reality, the frame is this illogical connection. It's hidden, so that, and it's absurd because you shouldn't find it. But so when I found it, in my opinion, I found it, and it resulted in the beginning of defining the structure of this reality, in my opinion. So I mean is like I define reality from this absurd Detroit fractal. Oh, it's so absurd. I know, fucking idiots. But it's just how it is. So just imagine for yourself, if you created a world and you thought like, okay, it has to be efficient because it will be heavy on computation otherwise when you render it on the, I mean, it's like a computer game, so you render it, and if it's too complicated, it will fill up your memory and your hard disk drive on your simulated computer simulator or something. So you need the kind of fractal world, and to hide this fractal, you can't just hide it like in plain sight, which is you hide it in, like, let's say Israel, like, yeah, the world circles around Israel, and or the world circles around whatever, what is it, instead it has to be like, okay, the world circles around something completely weird, I consider it to be this weird thing considered to be Detroit, and that's weird as heck. And so big brain awareness or brain awareness is like, everything is in this world is this big neural net, and when I define this, when I try to see the construction of this reality with Detroit fractal, I see this. I kind of see the neural nets, I think, the brain, and start to connect myself to it in different parts. Like, I spread out on this brain, in my opinion, and because I'm, this is like a narcissistic part, and I'm sorry about that, So because I'm spread out on this neural brain, I happen to not only detect but also affect. Okay, because I detected for a long time. I presented how I detected things for a very long time, you know, if you follow my videos. And then all of a sudden I started to affecting. It was first the floods of summer 2021, I mean. And so I predicted that, and then it was other things. I don't even remember it, but and now it's this. But I think there will be more. And it was almost as if the more I looked into the Detroit fractal, it kind of invited me to look into more. It showed me, as you know, in if you listen to my videos. So let's start this, stop this narcissistic part now, and I leave that ego aside for a while and talk about something else similar. So in my opinion about like affecting reality, so affecting reality, in my opinion, for me at least, I think that we are, or I am, a catalyst. Okay, thank you for helping me to find that word. I got some help from one of the commenters. So a catalyst is a chemical. In chemistry, there is a chemical, right? A chemical that that speeds up a reaction. Okay, and that is what I think reality creators are doing. They speed up a reaction. And what do I mean by that? I mean like this. And I can only talk from my own experience. So I assume it's the same for you. So what reality creators do is that they see patterns from the future, in my opinion. And either they just see it in the form of facts on the internet, or they just see it in their surrounding. The future information just comes to them, and no one else can see this information because it is not, you're not an observer in the same way, as I said in my last video. Because an observer, information cannot travel back in time to a regular observer. There has to be some different kind of observer, which means that, and that's why other people cannot see it, because they are regular observers. So you see this thing, you see this pattern from the future, and you talk about it. And when you talk about it, you trigger it to happen faster, okay? Or I think you also can trigger it to not happen if you talk about it. And I will explain why. So first of all, if I talk about something that I think... let's talk more about what the catalyst is doing in this chemical. So there are two chemicals that will react and create something. And this reaction can be very slow. So a catalyst, I don't have a good example, you just have to Google it. Or don't Google, DuckDuckGo it, okay? So this catalyst, it will go into this, be a part of this reaction, but not being consumed, okay? And this is also something that can help you to avoid paranoia about your own safety. Like I am doing, I don't feel unsafe. I'm not feeling like, oh, there's a sniper that will take me out anytime, or like someone will come from behind. Like I felt a long time ago, I felt like, okay, someone will just take me out. I don't feel that anymore, because I don't I'm not paranoid. I believe that if you are a catalyst, which I consider myself to be, I'm a catalyst. And because I'm not really responsible, I just speed it up, I think. So if you're a catalyst, you are not consumed. Okay, so if we assume that the same kind of design, so you have like a smart design of everything, as above, so below, or like how it's in space, it's also in the miniature atoms, you know. So the same with the word catalyst. The catalyst has the same meaning, which is like, in chemistry you have something that is not consumed, you have the same thing in biology, and I think also in this we have catalyst, which is not consumed. It means that maybe I am even more safe than a regular person, because I maybe cannot be touched. Maybe that is damaging to the overall like neural network, the overall big brain, okay? And some people, I probably lost some people now on this, because it's getting weird, this discussion. Some people may like what I'm talking about. Okay, so patterns from the future, catalyst, and so this is also why you're not really morally and ethically responsible, because you're just a catalyst for something that is already bound to happen, or maybe not. As I said, I think you can avoid it to happen. Let's take that example. For example, if you see a pattern on investment, you see something, this will go very expensive, then I think you can stop it from happening by sharing that information. If you have a kind of goodwill and you want to share information about an investment, I think it's a bad idea. It will stop it from happening. It will feed into it to not happen, because this is very sensitive. I consider like investments to be very sensitive for the butterfly effect. And if you are a catalyst and you just do a little bit, it will go the wrong way. So that's an example where you can stop something from happening, in my opinion. Okay, another type of observer. Okay, yeah, so let's go forward. Someone mentioned pendulums, or what equal and opposite reaction. So in physics there's like the saying, or maybe it's even a law in physics, I don't remember it, the name of it, but for every force there's an equal and opposite force, and that means that there is no acceleration, I guess, as long as you have the forces takes out each other. And yeah, what can I say about that? Yeah, so we have this, there's also this pendulum, and the pendulum is a sign of our duality also. So we have the pendulum goes back and forth between two states or something like that, and these pendulums that are everywhere, they cause us to have two brains, like the right and left brain, and like copy of everything on right and left. Yeah, by the way, I didn't tell you, I'm going to go chaos now. So in this Astroworld music festival, the same day, the artist called Astro, he died. So we have Astroworld, where many people had heart attacks, And then we have Astro. He did the song Red Red Wine. You know, Red Red Wine. He sang it. I don't think he did it, but he sang it. And his name is Astro, you see, Astro World. And Astro, it means star. I think it is Latin, star. And you know, the star in our sky, it's the sun. Okay, so we have the sun connection again. Okay, I don't know what to say more. I just wanted to say these things. So I guess that's all. Let's just talk about this. I'm not going to use this paper anymore, so I put it in my pocket. Let's see. So yeah, let's just talk about catalyst again, okay? Or you can turn this off if you want. So I want to repeat it. I think that when you interact with this fractal, which is a feedback loop from the future, you become a catalyst. Okay, I can tell more about that actually now, I realize. So this a catalyst is, or a feedback loop is when something goes back in time, and when you actually talk about it, you're going to strengthen the resonance of the information going back in time. You're going to make it so strong, this feedback loop, and that makes it more prone to happen, in my opinion. So in the same way as you are a catalyst, you speed up something. It's exactly the same thing. You speed up something, and that might make you, if it happens to you at some time, it might or may or something, I don't know, it may make you scared of your safety, but then you just have to think about the catalyst, because the catalyst is not consumed. And I think in this kind of quantum, or whatever we call it, quantum reality, or I don't want to talk about physics, I'm not that good at it actually anymore. So in that world, I think we can consider us being like a chemical. I mean, we don't have this big awareness that is competing with survival of the fittest or whatever in this, because all you know is about being aware, and all you know is about what awareness is, and that awareness is mostly in this, at least we can assume, it's isolated to being here. And okay, some people believe in this higher self or something that is the best of us, but place that is a bit on another level, which is this looking into the patterns from the future. And I can actually see some of these patterns in the charts, in like stock charts. And as I said, I'm a bad investor, so I haven't learned how to profit from it correctly yet. But I will, I'm sure of that, it will happen. And when it happens, I have to be really careful about not telling anyone about, and so should you. If you manage to understand the patterns, you shouldn't in investing, you shouldn't talk about it, at least not too much, because it's this sensitive butterfly effect. So, so what, where were I? Yeah, so in this other layer of reality, maybe we are more like a chemical or a biology, small. We are just small. Maybe we are just small particles of this greater, bigger thing, okay? And if we are small particles, it's not far from talking about enzymes and I have to take up the note because I forgot the name. Enzymes and catalyst, okay? It's not far from talking about being a catalyst, being this. I mean, it's almost like you are this, you become this mathematical, or, yeah, a catalyst, simply. It seems weird that, okay, I'm talking a lot of shit right now, and sorry about that. But I will try to explain it, because I want to do that. So, because here, in 3D, we feel so special, feel so special about being alive here and perceiving and seeing everything. We see this a tree, I walk here, I see something else, and I'm so special. I see a lot of things here, but so does a particle. A particle perceives the magnetism and the electrical fields in the surrounding in a way, because it will interact with it. In the same way, it's almost deterministic. So down here we are, we seem so, the thing that you feel is like free will, and maybe it's not that impressive in the bigger picture. And I'm going to make you feel bad now, that wasn't a purpose. So but when you go into this, see the pattern and become a catalyst, I think you don't have to think about, oh, it's all these awarenesses that are interacting, because and that's too chaotic to be so simple as a catalyst and reactions. But I think it simply is, everything is simply on the bigger picture, it's just chemical reactions. What we see here in the bigger picture is just a chemical reaction. Okay, that's what I want to say. Okay, whatever. Let's just end this video. I think I am happy with this. And I think it's all. I hope I don't get lost in woods. I don't think it will happen. So, another not so important video where I walk in the woods and ramble. And if you want me to be more precise and more planned, you can leave a comment about that, and I will consider doing that, and it would make me do less videos also, because I'm just talking like I think for myself here, and that's all. So if you don't like it, you can leave a comment. I can also stop doing this kind of, it's okay for me also. So bye bye.